Welcome to War India News Hour. Gaming industry garnering more interest for the millennials. India's gaming industry is valued at $913 million with an estimated number of gamers to touch 628 million by this year itself. Majority would be recreational gamers. There are many youngsters who are living from gaming. They either get into esports, which involves competing, or gaming for audiences on streaming platforms like YouTube and Twitch. Both avenues appear lucrative. According to a recent report by Maple Capital Advisors, many industry players are now looking to enter India and invest in the country's gaming market. While the digital gaming industry is soaring high, the virtual reality entertainment zone are also picking up pace. Gamers today are making a career out of streaming and competing in esports. There are over 400 gaming companies here, and India is also one of the top 5 mobile gaming markets in the world with a 13% share of global games sessions, according to a report by Deloitte India. Competitive e-sporting is divided into 4 main genres. There are fighting games like the Mortal Kombat, first-person shooters that is Counter-Strike and Battlefield, real-time strategy, Hearthstone, and multiplayer online battle that is like your battle arena. However, each game has a set of rules laid down either by the International Esports Federation or Asian Electronic Sports Federation, based on which tournaments, both national and international, are organized. India has the potential to become the AR or VR, that is augmented reality or virtual reality, and casual gaming development factory of the world if talent is nurtured and infrastructure is built. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Upstocks data breach leaks 56 million files. Upstocks is the second largest Indian stockbroking firm with 2.5 million customers, with the stockbroking firm that has leaked the sensitive information of 56 million KYC of its customers online. It is the biggest KYC leak. The ransomware group Shiny Hunters breached the Upstocks server. The leaked data include customers' names, email, date of birth, PAN, bank details, and KYC information like their password, PAN, cancelled check, signature pictures, etc. Microsoft to enhance its AI portfolio, ready to invest $16 billion. Microsoft is in talks to acquire AI and speech company Nuance Communications in a deal that would value the company at about $16 billion. This would be Microsoft's second largest ever after its $26.2 billion deal to buy LinkedIn in 2016. Microsoft has invested heavily in artificial intelligence in recent years. Last year, the company unveiled an enormous supercomputer for AI work that contained 285,000 processor core. Samsung unveils world's first smart monitors with built-in OTT apps. Samsung has launched the world's first do-it-all smart monitor that lets users stream Netflix, YouTube, Apple TV and other OTT apps, as well as work connecting their PCs and smartphones. The smart monitor allows users to remotely access files from their PC or laptop located elsewhere. With this, consumers no longer have to choose between different screens for varied uses, as this smartphone brings it all together and offers the flexibility to smoothly transition from working and learning to entertaining oneself, said Puneet Sethi, VP Consumer Electronics Enterprise Business at Samsung India. DuckDuckGo cautioned people to block Google's new tracking technique. DuckDuckGo, the privacy-focused search engine, has slammed the new ad tracking method by Google, saying it is bad for privacy and puts the users in a group based on their browsing history, and any website can get that group ID to target and fingerprint them. It has also claimed that the FLOC, or Federal Learning of Cohorts, tracking method has been automatically turned on for millions of Google Chrome users, and the technology to provide a more privacy-focused way to track users and serve ads to them. HP launches its Chromebook with 11th Gen Intel Core processor. HP Chromebook X360 14C has been updated with 11th generation Intel Core processors. The new laptop continues to offer a convertible form factor that featured on previous Chromebook X360 versions. The convertible Chromebook also includes a fingerprint reader and a backlit keyboard. The Chromebook X360 14C 2021 is aimed at students and workers connected to the internet for their homes. With this, let's find up for the day. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest updates and stay tuned. Thank you.